One of the most annoying things about using AI chatbots like ChatGPT is how lengthy prompts need to be to get a really good answer. So here's the solution. If you use the same types of prompts again and again, it's definitely worth learning a feature called snippets or text expanders. And these are basically building blocks of text that you can basically insert anywhere on your page. And they're great for email responses, templates, little short phrases, and as I mentioned, great for AI prompts. So this feature is actually built into iOS and Mac. And it's under the keyboard settings. So I'm on a Mac right now. And if I go into keyboard and I go into text replacements here, you can insert any longer phrase and have a shortcut for it. One of the most common ways I use this on my iOS devices on my Mac is entering email addresses. And what I do is rather than typing my email address every single time, I have a short phrase that I use and I always use @. And I have numbers assigned to all my different email addresses. So I do @, and I do 5, automatically an email address populates. Now, sweetfantasy@aol.com is not my email address, but I wanted to show you guys an example of that. So text replacement on Macs and iOS devices is fantastic. I highly encourage everyone to use them, especially for email address input. But I also use Raycast Snippets because it has a feature called dynamic text where you can basically insert additional text along with your snippet. And I'm going to show you that in a second here. I'm going to call up Raycast by using my hotkey, which is Option S. And these are all my different snippets. If you aren't familiar with Raycast, check out my video in the description box that I go through this app. It's, I think, one of the best apps on the Mac. I think everyone should have it. But one of the cool features of Raycast is it has this snippet feature. So again, these are all my snippets. And I'm going to use this cooking assistant snippet here. It's very, very lengthy. It's very long. But it makes ChatGPT so much better as my cooking assistant because it follows these specific instructions. I could, of course, put this on a document, copy and paste it, but this makes it so much easier. I'm going to go into ChatGPT here, and my short phrase is @cook, and automatically, you saw how quick that was. It basically populated my entire prompt, and again, very, very long. I'll hit enter here and it'll go down and it'll say, what do you want to cook today? Because it knows exactly how this prompt is structured. It just makes it so much better. So that's one simple way to use Raycast snippets. Now I'm going to use Raycast snippets again, but this time with dynamic text. And I'm going to go into another large language model. And this one's called Claude AI, which I discovered a few weeks ago. I think it's really, really good. Definitely check out Claude AI. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have it generate some email headlines for my newsletter. So I have a draft here in Notion, and you can see I have here, and what I'll do is I'll just copy all this, and I wanted to read this draft and generate me 10 different headlines that I can start brainstorming. So I'll go back here, and what I'll do is I'll do @headline, and automatically not only has it inserted the prompt I've created, but it's also inserted the last thing I've copied on my clipboard. Send, and it'll start generating these top 10 headlines that I can start using for brainstorming. So let me open up Raycast and show you what that looks like. So I have the prompt here, and then I have everything I pasted in green here. So if I could take something like cheat codes, if I do copy this into my clipboard and I go back to Raycast, you could see cheat codes has been inserted. This is the dynamic text I was talking about. So this basically saves you keystrokes by inserting your snippet as well as dynamic text. And there's other advanced features within Raycast that you can use snippets for, but the clipboard feature is fantastic. So definitely if you have prompts that you use again and again, use something like text expander, Raycast snippets, or even built-in feature on your Mac or your iOS devices to make it so much faster. Thanks for watching. Take care of yourself, and I'll see you guys in the next one.